Hello everyone, welcome back to this channel. This is Saroja. In previous videos, we have learned about what is lifespan development, difference between growth and development, and different stages of development. And also we learned about the first stage in development, that is prenatal stage. Now, let us see about the infancy period in this video. Infancy is a period from birth to end of second week. In this period, the baby is considered as an infant. Infancy is the early period of existence of a baby as an individual rather than as a parasite in the mother's body. Here, we compare the baby as a parasite because the baby in the mother's womb depends on her mother. But when the baby is out to the external world, the infant individually operates specific functions such as breathing, swallowing, voluntary movements, crying, etc. Infancy is generally subdivided into two periods, the period of the parturient and the period of the neonate. The period of the parturient is from birth to 15 to 30 minutes after birth. This period begins when the fetal body has emerged from mother's womb and lasts until the umbilical cord has been cut and tied. Until this is done, the infant continues to be a parasite and makes no adjustments to the postnatal environment. Now, the period of neonate. It is from cutting and tying of the umbilical cord to approximately the end of the second week of postnatal life. During this period, the infant must make adjustments to the new environment outside the mother's body. Now, let's see some of the attributes involved in infancy. As infancy contains only 2 weeks of period, it is considered as shortest of all developmental periods. During this shortest time, the fetus must adjust to life outside the uterine walls of mother, where the baby has lived for approximately 9 months. Next, plateau in development. In the womb, the fetus grows rapidly for 9 months. Suddenly, this growth comes to stop after birth. This halt in growth and development at this stage is necessary for making complete adjustments to postnatal environment. Once adjustments complete, infants resume their growth and development in the later stages. Infancy is a preview of later development. It is highly impossible to predict what the individual's future development will be on the basis of development apparent at birth. Newborn behavior is more like a preface to a book than like a table of contents yet to be unfolded. So, no one can easily predict the child's future by considering the few days after birth of a child. Hazardous period. It is hazardous both physically and psychologically. Physical hazards due to difficulties of making the necessary adjustments to new environment. Psychological hazards are due to the impact of attitudes on infant by different people surrounding them. Infancy is a time of radical adjustments. Even the development of human starts at the moment of birth, but the birth is merely an interruption to developmental pattern that started at the moment of conception. Because it is a stage where the baby must adjust to changes in the outer environment. Some of the adjustments of infancy is clearly discussed in the next slide. Infants must make 4 major adjustments before they can resume their developmental progress. They are temperature changes, breathing, sucking and swallowing, and elimination. There is a constant temperature of 100 degrees Fahrenheit in the uterine sac. While temperatures in the hospital or home may vary from 60 to 70 degrees Fahrenheit. Until the baby is in mother's womb, the baby breathes, receives food, and eliminates waste products through umbilical cord. But when the fetus is out of the mother's womb, these actions must be done by the infant voluntarily. These are the major adjustments should be done by the infant through this stage. These are some of the indications of the infant facing difficulty in adjustment to postnatal life: loss of weight, disorganized behavior, infant mortality. Loss of weight. It occurs if an infant finds difficult in sucking and swallowing food from his mother. Disorganized behavior. You might think that how we can conclude or find an infant's behavior in the first 2 weeks of life. Here, the disorganized behavior includes irregularities in breathing rate, frequent urinations and defecations, and wheezing. This occurs due to partly pressure on the brain during birth. Infant mortality. The rate of infant mortality during the first 2 days of prenatal period is high even in these days, but the causes of infant mortality may be varied. Up to now, we have seen difficulties of infants in adjustments to postnatal life. Now, we see what are the conditions that influencing adjustment. First one is prenatal environment. Already you have learned about prenatal environment. Here, I just give you a brief description about how prenatal life influence postnatal life. The baby is healthy only if the mother's health is good psychologically and physically. So, a healthy prenatal environment will contribute good adjustments to postnatal life. Some of the conditions that cause poor prenatal life are poverty, malnutrition, negligence of mother, and maternal stress, etc. Next one is postnatal care. Postnatal care during the first 3 to 4 days after birth will be by hospital personnel. After that, mother needs to take care of the infant at home by taking assistance from infant's father or relatives. Three aspects play a major role at this stage: amount of attention, amount of stimulation, degree of confidence, especially from mother, plays a vital role in postnatal care. Next one is parental attitudes. Parental attitudes towards infant plays a major role in adjustment to postnatal life of infants. Parents whose attitude are favorable treat the infant in ways that encourage good adjustments. Parents must be prepared for parental duties. Sometimes the mother shows disinterest towards the babies because of bad experiences during delivery or some traditional beliefs which causes problems for infants in adjustments. Next one is length of gestation period. Usually the length of gestation period is 280 days after conception. If a baby is born early, they are considered as prematures, and if they arrive late, considered as postmatures. Premature babies usually experience complications in adjusting to postnatal life, which causes serious effect on future adjustments. Postmature infants usually adjust more quickly and more successfully to the postnatal environment than the infant born at full term, if only the fetus doesn't damage at birth. Next one is experiences associated with birth. Two birth experiences have a major effect on postnatal adjustments. They are the extent to which the mother is medicated during birth process and the ease or difficulty with which the infant establishes respiration. The last one is kind of birth. The kind of birth an infant experiences shows a great effect in adjustment to postnatal life. Let's see different kinds of birth. These are the five kinds of birth. The first one is natural or spontaneous birth. The infant who has been born spontaneously usually adjusts more quickly and successfully to postnatal life. The next one is breech birth. In breech birth, the buttocks appear first, followed by legs and finally head. Here, in this delivery, there is a higher risk for baby to get stuck in the birth canal. The next one is transverse birth. In transverse birth, the fetus is positioned crosswise in mother's uterus. Instruments must be used for delivery unless the position can be changed before the birth process begins. In this delivery, there is a chance of prolapse of umbilical cord or uterine rupture. Next one is instrumental birth. When the fetus is too large to emerge spontaneously, instruments must be used to complete the delivery process. The last one is cesarean section. The baby is brought into the world through a slit made surgically in the mother's abdominal wall. If there is indication of complications in delivery through birth canal. Sensory capacities of infants include vision, hearing, smell, taste, organic and skin sensitivities. Vision. Newborn infants can see, but their visual field is only about one half that of adults because the rods are undeveloped except around the fovea. Hearing. At first, the middle ear is blocked with amniotic fluid for few days. Hearing normally improves within the first 3 or 4 days after birth as the amniotic fluid drains from middle ear. Next one is smell. The infant can distinguish odors and it is shown by crying, head turning, and attempts to withdraw from unpleasant stimuli. The cells of smell are well developed at birth itself. Next one is taste. The infant can identify the taste and gives positive reactions for sweet stimuli and gives negative responses like crying in response to salt, sour, and bitter stimuli. Last one is organic and skin sensitivities. Sensitivity to hunger, thirst, and also sense organs for touch, pressure, and temperature are fully developed at birth. Senses to cold is more highly developed than senses to heat. The sensitivity to pain is weak for the first 2 days of postnatal life and then improves rapidly. Hazards of infancy. Even infancy is a stage of short duration, it is one of the most hazardous periods in lifespan. Hazards at this time may be physical and psychological, or sometimes it may be both. These hazards can affect the future adjustments of the infant. We have already discussed about the effects caused by unfavorable prenatal environments, difficult and complicated births, and post-maturity problems and pre-maturity problems, and also the infant mortality. Now, we see effects caused by multiple birth. Children of multiple birth are usually smaller and weaker than singletons. As a result of crowding during the prenatal period, which inhibits fetal movements. The higher the number of fetuses in the pregnancy, the greater the risk for early birth. Now, let's see some of the psychological hazards of infancy stage. The first one is traditional beliefs about birth. One of the traditional beliefs about birth that has received considerable scientific attention concerns the effect of time of birth on the future development of infant. Anyway, there is no reliable evidence to date that individuals born at one season of the year or on one day of the week are brighter and achieve greater successes in life than those born at other times. Next one is helplessness. Infantile helplessness becomes a serious psychological hazard. The reason for this is that parents wonder if they are capable of assuming the care of their newborn babies, and this in turn makes them nervous and anxious. Next one is individuality of the infant. If parents remember their earlier born children as crying very little at night after being taken home from the hospital or having little difficulty in nursing or keeping down their nourishment, they will be concerned if the new infant experiences feeding difficulties or cries every night without apparent reason. Parental concern is then expressed in the treatment of the infant. This in turn affects the infant's adjustments to postnatal life and tends to increase the severity of the problems that concerns the parents. The next one is developmental lag. Some infants lag behind the norm in their development during the infancy period. The infants most likely to show developmental lag are those who born prematurely or who were injured at birth. Even a healthy full-term infant may show some developmental lag due to some minor reasons such as inadequate mother's milk. Whatever the cause it may be, it is always a source of concern to parents that affects the way they handle the infant's needs. The last one is new parent blues. States of depression, often called new parent blues, are almost universal among new parents. These depressive states tend to be more pronounced in mothers than in fathers, and in parents of first babies than in those who have already had one or more children. In new mothers, depressive states are partly physical and partly psychological. This occurs due to some glandular changes accompanying pregnancy and after childbirth. Thank you. Stay tuned to get more information about further developmental stages.